Action back here at the Physical Activities Complex on the campus of the University of Waterloo. We'll have the action for you live, followed by the men's game. But first, we send it courtside for the national anthem as the crowd continues to stream into the pack, and both coaches at their benches getting set for the national anthem. We'll send it down courtside for the playing of the national anthem here at the pack. Get so used to a live and sung national anthem that it's a little bit of a change to get back to the instrumental variety. So we can give you our starting lineups brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department. Go Warriors Go, the latest in recreation and varsity athletics on the campus of the University of Waterloo. The Guelph Gryphons start today. Marley Freeman, number 5, a 5'6 guard in her fourth year out of Aurelia. Number 8, Alyssa Short, a 5'10 guard in her second year out of Waterloo. Number 13, Kayla Goodhoof, and that name may be familiar. Her brother, Alan, played for the Warriors for 5 seasons on the men's squad. She's a 5'11 forward in her third year out of Oakville. Number 14, Erica McFadden, a 5'6 guard in her first year out of Oklahoma. And number 21, Jasmine Douglas, a 6th center in her fifth year out of Guelph. They're coached by Tom O'Brien, assistant coach Tim Doherty, Karen Bremner, and Howard Keel. For the hometown University of Waterloo Warriors, they're starting number 4, Jackie Rodriguez, a 5'8 point guard in her first year out of Waterloo. Number 7, Mackenzie Loheed, a 5'11 forward, her third year out of Owen Sound. Number 15, Sam McIntyre gets another start, the 5'10 guard in her second year out of Waterloo. Number 21, Kate Quincy, a 6'2 forward out of Stratford, who is back with that little head wound, and you'll notice a little bit of gauze, a bandage on her forehead because of a cut that she sustained in the last game against Mac. And rounding out the starters, number 23, Erica Persson, a 5'10 guard in her first year out of Lund, Sweden. Again, the Warriors enter this game winless, currently on a 31-game winless streak. 0-13 this season, the regular season. They did win a couple in the preseason. And the Guelph Gryphons, who were on fire in the preseason, and they also win the tip right now, have not won a game since November. They get the ball inside to Goodhoof with the right hook driving in right through the defense, and she easily lays it in. Coach Slip telling us the key to the game. It's really one thing, transition D. Kate Quincy tries to answer back, does so, flying through the paint and laying it in from the right side. Coach Slip telling us that Guelph is a team that likes to take lots of quick shots, and Goodhoof, after the block on the shot attempt by McFadden, Goodhoof now with 4 quick points, and Guelph leads Waterloo 4-2. Quincy tried to get up into Rodriguez, who saves it from going out of bounds, into McIntyre, lobbing it to Loheed. Loheed, his double team, kicks it outside into McIntyre, just inside of the charity stripe. May have traveled, no whistle, and her shot's a bit too strong. Guelph gets it into the high post to Goodhoof. Outside into McFadden. She and Freeman play a little catch. McFadden puts up a shot. It's an air ball, and the loose ball is picked up by McIntyre. She quickly gets up to person, it's a DeLohe who can't finish with the right hand right under the net, and Douglas comes down with the rebound for Guelph. We've played about 90 seconds of the first quarter. It's been quick, as a quick drive in by Short. Her lay attempt is short, and Loheed comes down with it. Quickly up to Rodriguez, who will push the ball down court to McIntyre by herself. Easily banks it off the glass and in. Game's tied at 4 with 8:12 to go in the first quarter. Quickly coming down and being fouled is Erica McFadden. So she'll go to the line. The foul being called against Rodriguez. That'll be her first and the first team foul on the Warriors. Erica McFadden in her first year. Prized recruit, highly recruited by a number of NCAA Division I schools as well. She played under Coach Slip on the club level in the last year, and Coach Slip was pretty disappointed. Tried to recruit her here to Waterloo, and she elected instead to go to Guelph. She misses the free throw attempt. She's been an instant contributor off the bench, averaging 12.3 points per game, 3.5 rebounds, and shooting from beyond the arc 37% on the season. Loaded from the near elbow, takes down a dribble, driving in, outside, into Bear, back over to Loheed with 3 on the shot clock, tries a hook, partially blocked by Short, who lobs it up to Goodhoofs. Side to McFadden, jumper, it's good. Coach Slip talked about those quick shots that Guelph will take, and there was another one, quick release, said when they go in, this Guelph team can really heat it up and go on some runs, but when they start missing, it's bad news, and a whistle called against McFadden as Rodriguez was driving in from the left side. Guelph leads Waterloo, it's 8-4 with 7:26 to go in the first quarter. Swatha Kuvalendinen comes in to she's replacing Person. Kulin Develin in her first year out of Calgary, mechanical engineering program at Waterloo. Lobs in corner to Rodriguez. She cuts towards the paint. Gia Spropoulos also into the game, replacing Kunsi. As the Warriors pass it around down low, it's knocked out of bounds by Guelph. Warriors will have just 3 seconds on shot clock. And Kulin Develin will inbound into Spropoulos. Quick shot, hits it from about 10 feet. G with her first points of the evening. And then Guelph turns the ball over. And they get an earful from their head coach, Tom O'Brien, in his 42nd year coaching women's basketball. He was a coach here at Waterloo for 8 seasons. The Warriors reached the playoffs 6 of those 8 years. As Bear has it stripped by Goodhoofd. Kulin Develin comes back. The rebound off the strong shot from Goodhoofd, picked up by Bear. Lobs it up to Rodriguez. Warriors trailing by 2. It's 8-6. Kulin Develin into the corner to Bear. Lobbing into the post to Loheed. Loses her dribble. Freeman comes up with it for the Gryphons. 3-on-2 break. No-look pass into Goodhoofd, kicks it outside to Freeman, inside the arc for a long 2. Sweet stroke and nothing but net. Warriors now trailing 10-6. Person and Kunsi about to re-enter the game for the Warriors. Getting some last-minute instructions from Tyler Slip. Bear lobbing it inside into Loheed, who again can't get that point-blank shot drop. Loheed, who's been such an energetic part of the offense in the last few games, if not since becoming a walk-on for this Warriors squad, just not with a hot hand so far. There's a miss by Goodhoofd, and Warriors come up with possession. We approach the midway point of the first quarter. Warriors trailing by 4. It's 10-6. Rodriguez gets stuck at the elbow, gets it over Spropoulos, spinning around on Douglas, puts up a shot off the glass. But the official on the baseline calls the travel. Our officials, that was Ian Pierce calling the travel. Randy Aldworth, Ian Pierce, and Farnoud Kazemzedeh are their officials so far for the evening for the women's game. Erin Tidley will see her first action for the Gryphons as they make some wholesale changes. Vanessa Rampato, a first-year player to Niagara Falls, also into the game. And a whistle on the play. It looks like person reached in. Van Balkum, Dana Van Balkum, second year out of Hamilton, comes in as McFadden and Goodhoof take a seat, as does Barbara Henrik Peters. So the bounce pass from number 7, now donning the black, gold, and red of Guelph. Aaron Tilley was passing around, the miss by Rampato. Down with it are the Warriors. Natasha Stojakovic is in the game for the Warriors. McIntyre misses the shot right under the basket, but she's fouled. She'll go to line to shoot two. Warriors with Kulin Develin, Person, Stojakovic, and Quincy. McIntyre makes her first. Sam, a 73% free throw shooter, misses the second, but down with it is Kunsi. And she's fouled as she tried to put the shot up between Rampato and Tilley. And Kate will go to line. Tilley had some very warm greeting, got some very warm greetings from the number of the Warriors just before the game. Kunsi misses her first. Kate, a 69% free throw shooter on the season. Coach Slip called Tilley one of his favorite players, battled all the time, and he loved that about her, as Quincy made the back end. He said, just turns out that wasn't what he was looking for, whether it be the program or the school. And he says he wishes her the best and hopes that she's found what she's looking for with the Gryphons at the University of Guelph. Rodriguez will come back into the game. She'll replace Person. As Person picked up her second foul just moments ago, we're less than 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Warriors trailing by 2. It's 10-8. Tilley in the corner being guarded by McIntyre. Switch is made. Bounces it over to Rampato. She gets trapped in there by Stojakovic. Kicks it outside. And then no whistle on the play by the miss by Henrik Peters. And a shot clock violation called against the Gryphons with some good defense by the Warriors. Coach O'Brien of Guelph said he found the Warriors on tape to be a very hardworking team and they played very good defense. And they just stalled the Gryphons' offensive attack right there. Quincy loses a dribble for a moment, getting it up to Rodriguez. Jackie waits for the other Warriors to get in position, uses a screen from Quincy. McIntyre wanting to get it into the post. She'll get into the paint. Puts the jumper as the defender, Henrik Peters, fell down and hits the ball to drop, and it's 10-all. 4:13 to go in the first quarter. Freeman driving in, the little underhand lane attempt with the left hand doesn't fall. Stojakovic bounces it over to Kulin Develin. She'll get it up to Kunsi as Guelph does a slight press with one player in the front court. Kunsi bounces it over to Devlin, knocked out of bounds by Van Balkum. And a whistle on the play, however. Warriors will be bounding. Bear replacing Kulin Develin. Freeman takes a seat in her place. Kate McTavish, a second-year forward, six-footer, out of Waterloo. McTavish attended KCI. Hames knotted up at 10, 3:50 to go in the first quarter. McIntyre lobbing it into Bear's double team down low. And a little over-aggressive was Barbara Henrik Peters. That's the fifth team foul on Guelph. Warriors with three team fouls at this point, so it takes Bear to the line. And she asks Quincy and Stojakovic to back up, and Maddie makes the first. Bear on the season, just 13 attempts up to this point from the line, 46%, but she makes both, and giving the Warriors a two-point lead. 3:40 to go in the first quarter. Gets past Quincy. Looked like she traveled on the play, no whistle, and Aaron put up that shot, was fouled, will go to the line to shoot two. McIntyre picks up the foul, good hoofed. who replaces Enric Peters. Tilly on the season, a 50% free throw shooter, makes her first. And misses second, so Akovic keeps the ball up high, waiting to get the ball out to somebody, but it's ripped out of her hands by Goodhoeft, kicking it over to the left wing. Into McFadden. McFadden being guarded by Rodriguez, and the screen was put on her hard, freeing up McFadden, who got the jumper to fall. Guelph leads 13-12, 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. Kenzie Loheed about to re-enter the game for the Warriors. Rodriguez into wide-open Stojakovic for the jumper from the near elbow. Hits that one. Natasha is still getting her stride. They've played a handful of games so far this season. Injuries and inexperience kept her off the court for the much of the first half. Van Volkum into the corner to Tilly. She pulls up and has the ball partly blocked, but partially because her arm would hit. So Aaron will go to the line to shoot two. Loheed replaces Kunze. Kunze, that was her first foul on that last play as Aaron misses her first. Warriors shooting 50%, 4 of 8. Guelph already with 15 attempts, made 7 of it for 47%. As McIntyre lobbed it down court, Bear tried to save it from going out of bounds, and the Warriors turned the ball over very quickly. McIntyre had expected Rodriguez to sprint down the court, and it didn't happen. Van Balkum will inbound for Guelph, kicks it up top to Tilly, who hands it off to Goodhoeft. Top of the key, being guarded by Loheed. Gets right past Loheed. No help. Easily lays it in with the left-handed lay-in. Warriors trailing 16-14, 2:20 to go in the first quarter. Rodriguez trying to get past Van Volkum. And McIntyre lobs it in to Stojakovic, whose shot is a bit too strong off the glass. Tilly came down with a rebound. McFadden, a stutter step, gets Bear to fall on her backside, but down with the rebound, up the miss, was Loheed, who then turns the ball over. Tilly with a dangerous pass, saved by McIntyre from going out of bounds, and Rodriguez grabs it over to Stojakovic. A no-look pass to McIntyre, stolen by Goodhoeft on a two-on-one. Rodriguez runs some interference. Goodhoeft missed the lay-in attempt, but is there for the putback. We approach 90 seconds to go in the first quarter. Warriors trailing by 4. It's 18-14. Rodriguez tried to use a screen from Stojakovic. Wasn't quite in the right place. And Jackie forces her way into the basket. Is fouled. She'll go to the line as both teams independently at this point. Short and Douglas replace Tilly and McTavish. Stojakovic and McIntyre take a seat. Person comes back into the game along with Kunze. Jackie misses the first. Jackie on the season is 77% free throw shooter. Second one's up, rattles around, hung on the front of the iron, and then falls through the cylinder. Warriors trailing by 3, it's 18-15. Freeman nearly has it put a bounds. Douglas picks it up. And then a foul called as McKenzie trying to get good position, forcing Douglas to step out of bounds, but it might have been the hip check that did that. So here's Jasmine Douglas at the line. 1:13 to go in the first quarter. Douglas makes the first. Douglas, a 78% free throw shooter on the season, averaging just 7 points a game. for Douglas, a little bit below what she averaged last season, 11 points, 10 rebounds, 1.5 assists. This season down to the 7 points, almost 8 rebounds a game. And just from the field, shooting just under 32%. Not good for a big. Quincy had the shot, or pass, partially blocked, but right into the hands of Loheed, who lays it in. Warriors trail by 3, less than a minute to go in the first quarter. It's 20-17. Guelph gets it up into Short, who shots off. Quincy down with it. 45 seconds to go in the first quarter. And Kate bringing the ball down court. Warriors really shorthanded due to injuries. Rodriguez into the high post. Loheed, help comes, gets it into Quincy all by herself for a 15-footer. That one's a bit too strong. Knocked out of bounds, and the official down there, that's Randy Aldsworth, says out of bounds off the Warriors. It's Guelph ball. 29.5 seconds to go. Warriors trailing by 3. It's 20-17. Freeman up into Short. Short gets past Quincy, and Quincy catches up over to Goodhoofs. Bounces it into Douglas, stolen, however, by the Warriors. Then Guelph steals it back over to Freeman. Her shot is strong. Douglas misses on the rebound attempt, grabs the other one. That one she puts back. 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Person will push the ball down court for the Warriors. 5 seconds to go. Little head fake. Passes it over to Rodriguez. Puts up a shot as the game clock here in the quarter expires. And that's how things will end here at the after one quarter, with the Warriors trailing by 5, it's 22-17. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN. Here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching University of Waterloo women's basketball on SSN Canada. Thanks for joining us. After one quarter of play, the Guelph Gryphons lead the Waterloo Warriors 22-17. It was a quarter the Warriors would probably be pretty happy about. A couple of misses and a couple of opportunities defensively to get a stop, which they weren't able to do, and that's really where this five-point deficit comes from. Number of turnovers, which cost as well late in that quarter, where folks just didn't have the focus on what opportunities were out there. A couple of sort of behind the back or no look passes got them into trouble. This is a team that really was being a young team, inexperienced team, needs to focus on those fundamentals, find the open receiver, if you will, and get the ball into them instead of trying to force a pass or try something a little too fancy. And what they're going to really work on in this second quarter, certainly, is that transition defense. Hot shooting team Guelph so far is they're shooting 41% from the field. Warriors at 46, but they've also, Guelph has also outshot the Warriors, had 9 more attempts from the field. That can be expected from this squad. As the Warriors inbound, dangerous pass from Person into Rodriguez, and get the ball back once again. And a miss on the play. Warriors grab the rebound over to Loheed. Outside of Person for 3. That one's just short. Rodriguez was there. Kicks it outside of Person again. Thought about a 3. Driving in. Had the ball knocked out of bounds. But the official on the baseline says it's Guelph ball. Freeman. Over to Goodhoof. Outside to Freeman for three. That one's strong. Loheed with a nice box set on Douglas. Grabs the rebound. Rodriguez to the baseline into Kunze. 15 on the shot clock. Kate to the other side of the paint into Loheed with a strong move. Right over top of short and gets that one to fall. The shot from McFadden falls from about 18 feet. Nice shot, and Guelph, again, with a bit of a hot hand from long range. Coach Slip said they need to control that. It's a team that can go on some serious runs if you're not careful on the defensive side of things. Vanessa Rampato will come back into the game. She'll replace Alyssa Short. Aaron Tilley about to re-enter the game as well for Guelph. She'll replace McFadden. Tilley with some decent minutes in that first quarter and her return to the physical activities complex. Could be dangerous pass into the paint into Person who has a block from behind by Tilley. And Guelph comes down with it. Goodhoft. Up into Freeman. Freeman, the fourth-year player orchestrating the offense, co-captain on this squad, to the other co-captain, that's Jasmine Douglas, who easily lays it in from the left side. Warriors trailing by seven. It's 26-19, 8:10 to go in the first half. Couldn't see it almost going head end-to-end. Outside into Bear for three. Hits it from the right wing. Madison Bear. Bear with 6 points against Mack back on Saturday. Douglas has it stripped by the Warriors, who trapped her on the far side. Over to Kunze, into Person. Person over to Bear. To Rodriguez for three. Far side. That one's a bit strong. And Erica comes down with it. Over to Kunze. Kunze into the paint. Outside. And Rodriguez again for three. That one's a bit short, and it goes out of bounds. It will be Guelph ball. Kulin Devlin and McIntyre we'll re-enter the game along with Spiropoulos, replacing Bear, Rodriguez, and Kunze. Freeman and Tilley play a little catch in the backcourt as Goodhoft keeps it from going out of bounds. Over to Freeman, then Tilley. Over to Goodhoft for three. Top of the key. Hits it. Answering back as the Warriors had worked their way back into the game. Person. Outlet pass to Kulin Devlin, who stops at the baseline. Over to Spiropoulos. Spiropoulos into Person. From the right wing, well off on the perimeter, being guarded by Tilley. Lobbing it to the near elbow into Loheed, and Loheed in the back by Rampato. Rampato will pick up the foul. That's the second team foul on Guelph. And the second one on Rampato. And McIntyre will inbound. Warriors with make that 14 on shot clock. Into Spiropoulos. Quick turnaround jumpers. A bit short. McIntyre was down there. And our lead official, Ian Pierce, calling Goodhoft on the play. Is Sam with some excellent work down in the paint. Rampato replaced by Short. Person is replaced by Rodriguez. Not a good inbound from McIntyre. The bounce pass was a bit short. Goodhoff came up with it. Over to Short, pushing the ball down court. Over to Douglas. Got the initial defender off her feet. That shot didn't go. Down with the rebound, however, was Short. Who's not so short, standing at 5'10", puts the ball in after the missed opportunity by her teammate. 6:41 to go in the first half. Warriors trailing 31-22. Loheed over to Kulin Devlin. And Rodriguez. Stolen, however, by Goodhoft. Will drive in from the right side. She's fouled by Rodriguez. Coach Slip told us last game that he really only has a handful of players who can bring the ball down court. Rodriguez, Person, Kunze. And anytime it gets into someone else's hands to sort of quarterback the ball down court, they can get in trouble or something. They really hurt them against Mack, who played, press full court the entire game. And here, Guelph, obviously watching the tape from the last Warriors game, they know that if they put even just a little bit of pressure in, contest any opportunity to get the ball into one of those ball handlers' hands, it's going to cause some fits for the Warriors, and it's done just that as the Warriors trail by 9, 31-22 with 6:29 to go here in the first quarter. We'll take a quick break. You're watching Warriors Women's Basketball on SSN. Back here at the pack on the campus of the University of Waterloo, you're watching Warriors Women's Basketball on SSN Canada. Thanks for joining us. Game number one of our doubleheader, the men's game coming up at about 8 p.m. here on SSN. You'll just have to go to the link for men's basketball. Goodhift misses the first. Goodhift, 63% free throw shooter. Deep knee bend, makes the second, and extending the Gryphons' lead to a round number, a nice 10 for them, as there's still 6.5 minutes to go, and McIntyre turns the ball over on the inbound pass. The second time the Warriors have done that in an inbound pass. Tilly to Douglas on the perimeter, into the corner, into short. Going one-on-one with Spropolis. It's around Spropolis, lays it in. Pullen Devlin was there for help, but Short did a nice cut just away from her and cut right back to the basket. McIntyre bounces it over to Rodriguez, then over to Glenn Devlin with 10 on the shot clock. And then McIntyre trying to get Loheed to get into the high post. Had Glenn Devlin on the near side all by herself for three. They didn't find her. Tilly, quick outlet pass into Goodhift, lays it in easily. And again, Guelph will press, back up a little bit, as Rodriguez is a ball handler and easily gets over midcourt. Hands it off to McIntyre, being guarded by Goodhift. Down to Spiropoulos, spinning around on Douglas, kicking it out to Devlin. Back over to Spiropoulos, facing up, now backing in to Douglas. Quick turnaround, is a bit short. Down there with the rebound, it was Loheed, grabbed the rebound, but brought it down to the floor, and then the shot clock expires. Looked like it went off the bottom of the iron on the previous miss, but the Warriors turn it over on the shot clock violation. It is Kulin Devlin, Spiropoulos, and Loheed are replaced by Kusi, Stojakovic, and Person. 5:10 to go in the first half. Warriors trailing by 14. It's 36-22. Henrik Peters swung it around to short, and then the miss by Beatty. Alex Beatty just onto the court for first action. The third-year player out of Woodstock. Couldn't see. Spinning around down low. But too strong, though. Right under the glass. And banked it too strong and out. And Guelph cut down with it. Heard Peters over to Beatty. Then to Tilly for a three ball that doesn't fall. Too strong. And Rodriguez will turn it around on transition. Going 4-on-3 outside of Person. Waited for one defender to get past her. Henrik Peters right in Person's face as she lobs it into Kunsi. And then a reach-in foul, most likely going against Short. We'll wait for the official call. That'll be the fourth team foul on Guelph with 4:27 to go in the first half. McTavish comes in replacing Douglas. Rodriguez replaced by Bear. Not the auspicious start the Warriors were hoping for. And home game number 3 of a 5-game homestand. Then they just have to go down to University on February 2nd to Laurier, then back home again. Quick pass from Short over to Tilly, outside, into Beatty. Over to Short, spinning around on Stojakovic, has it parsed, blocked by Quincy. But a foul on the play. Looked like she was fouled from the back because it looked like a clean block for Kate. Nope, they're going to call it on Kate. It's the second team foul on the Warriors and the second one on Kate. Then Balcom about to come into the game once again for Guelph. Short makes the first. Guelph Gryphons men's squad just entering the gym as we speak. The miss on the second. Good box out of the shooter by McIntyre, and she grabs the long rebound. 4 minutes precisely to go in the first half. Warriors trailing by 14. Bear put up a three, top of the key. That one's a bit short. Person almost there to get the rebound. However, it comes down in the hands of McTavish, has it stolen. Stojakovic too strong off the last person's down there. That one's a bit too short, but she's fouled by Short. And Erica will go to the line to shoot two. Then Volcom replacing Short. She heard the first foul on Short. And a timeout. It's called by Waterloo. It's not very often with a coach possibly icing their own shooter at the charity stripe. And with that, we'll take a quick break. You're watching Warriors women's basketball. The Warriors trailing the Gryphons 37-22. Back here at the PAC on the campus of the University of Waterloo, you're watching Waterloo Warriors women's basketball on SSN Canada. Thanks for joining us. Warriors trailing by 15. It's 37-22. And our discussions with the coaching staff of Guelph earlier in the week, head coach Tom O'Brien said to us that the key for his squad is to get scoring from multiple sources. Says when they get three or four players in double figures, that's when they win ball games. And so far tonight, it's looking good that that will most likely happen with Kayla Goodiff, the top scorer for the Gryphons, with 14, Erica McFadden with 8, Jasmine Douglas with 6, and Kate Short with 5. Person makes the first. The backhand is up. It's good. Substitution coming in. Caitlin Yallen, the fifth of five Yallen sisters to play at Guelph. She's a very good three-point shooter. She comes in to replace Beattie. Tilly getting it over into McTavish. Back over to Henry Peters. Tilly for three, far corner. That one's strong. And down with it is Stojakovic for the Warriors. Person lobbing into the post. Kunze. One-on-one with... waiting on the call there. One-on-one with Enrig Peters. And it goes out of bounds. They say it's Warriors ball. 14 on the shot clock. Bounce it into Stojakovic. Quick jumper. Too strong. Down with the rebound was McTavish. Here's Enrig Peters. Gets past Stojakovic. Help comes from McIntyre, but a little too late. She's called on the foul. So the shot drops and a three-point play opportunity for Barbara Enrig Peters. Enrig Peters in her second year. High-scoring game so far this season. In just 25 minutes, scored 12 points against Mac beginning of the month. Misses the three-point opportunity, but there McTavish was for the rebound, and then it goes out of bounds as on the ground was Yallen. And the Warriors will take over possession. 3 minutes exactly to go in the first half. Warriors trailing by 15. It's 39-24. McIntyre to the right wing to Bear. Bear, nice crossover dribble. Banks it in to Kunze. That's when you talk about court awareness. Maddie knowing exactly where she is, she was, where her teammate was. Smart pass, and Kate's fouled. Doesn't pick up that basket, but is at the line to shoot two. Unselfish play by the Warriors, number 8. Kate missed the first. one short. Aaron Tilley with a good box out, and then both squads doing a good job boxing out the free throw shooter. Nice pass from Tilley over to McTavish, who easily lays it in, waiting for the defender to get off her feet. Stojakovic lobbing it in to Bear, who knocks it out of bounds and off of Bear, and it will be another turnover by the Warriors. Rodriguez coming into the game. Freeman replaces Enric Peters for Guelph. Rodriguez in for McIntyre for the Warriors. Guelph gets it to Tilley. They have 3-on-2 in the offensive zone as Tilley drives in. Ran a play that she did many times as a Warrior. Couldn't get it to fall, however, but McTavish was there for the rebound. And finally, after a couple of attempts and having to get out of the hands of a couple of Warriors, McTavish lays it in easily. Warriors' leading scorer at this point is Sam McIntyre with 7. And now Guelph into team foul penalty at this point with their 5th foul there. Freeman with her first foul is replaced by Enric Peters. Stojakovic replaced by Spiropoulos for the Warriors. Rodriguez makes the first. Nice rotation on the shot. So you mentioned Jackie, a 77% free throw shooter, averaging 6 points a game this season in her first year in the OUA. 2 minutes to go in the second quarter, with the Warriors trailing 43-25, and a travel called against the Gryphons, and Guelph turns the ball over. Person inbounds to Kunze. She'll drive baseline, lost her dribble for a moment, grabs the loose ball, tried to pass it along the baseline, and stolen by Guelph. Enric Peters gets past Kunze and gets over midcourt. Lobs it into the corner, into Allen. It looks like a foul down low. It's going to go against McTavish as she was fighting for position with Kunze. Warriors trailing by 16 points. It's 43-27. 90 seconds to go in the first half. A foul called. Erica's lucky that she didn't pick up a travel, and that's the call that Tilley wanted made. Beatty about to enter the game for Guelph. She'll replace Tilley. Jasmine Douglas also, she'll come in to replace McTavish. Person at the line. Warriors as a team averaging 64% from the charity stripe, near the bottom of the pack, 40th in the CIS. But Erica improving that statistic slightly with those two. And now the Warriors trail by 14. 1:25 to go, and a travel call on Enric Peters. Person will it out. From the Warriors' side of midcourt, does so to Rodriguez. Back over to Person, who goes to the far side. Uses the screen from Kunze. Driving in, kicking it over Spiropoulos. The jumper, that one's a bit strong. Fight for the loose ball, and Jasmine Douglas, the big 50-year player for Gryphons, grabs it, getting it in Enric Peters. There's a jumper from the corner. That one is off by Beattie. Down with it is Bayer. Rodriguez, a little stutter step. Bounces it down at Kunze. Tries the lay-in. That doesn't go over the big redhead. That's Douglas. The miss by Spiropoulos. Fight for the loose ball. And it's Guelph ball. Always thrilled to have our next guest come and join us. Way up here in the in our press box, it's Greg Francis, the head coach of the Mets squad. And Greg, tough game on Saturday. Your thoughts about that Mac game?
You know what, it's Mac's playing pretty well, and I really like what they're doing over there. And the good thing for us is I think we're really close to them, and I think we can get a little bit better and catch up to Mac. But I just thought down the stretch they were a little bit better than us, and we were tied at halftime, but they were better than us down the stretch. So it was one of those where we could get some positive things out of it, but at the end of the day, they were better than us that day.
Well, there's certainly been a change, not just the fact that you guys have notched two in the win column in the second half, but a change sort of the atmosphere and the focus for this Warriors squad, maybe focusing a little more on the defensive side, and it's helped a little bit on the offense as well, it seems.
Yeah, you know what, if we play the defense the way I think we can, we have a chance to win every night. I didn't think we played great against Mac offensively by any stretch, but with our defense, you know, we have the game close, and we knocked down a couple more shots, it might have been a different game. So it's going to take all of that type of intensity on the defense end to keep it tight with Guelph tonight, see if we can pull one out at home.
What has been the secret? Is it just a matter of just defensively? Is it a matter of the team understands the systems, their defensive sets and positions, or is it more coaching in that break? What exactly was it that sort of changed the way the team has been playing?
You know what? It's communication. And it's not intuitive to a lot of guys, but they start to communicate better. And at the end of the day, we have some good athletes that can defend. So you can have whatever game plan you want, but with the athletes we have in the program right now, we can get out and defend and get into people and make it hard for them.
What are the keys for tonight's game? We talked a little bit about defense, but what's the keys against this Gryphons team? Also a pretty young team over there from Guelph.
Oh boy, a young team, but boy, they might be, just from scouting reports, they might be as tough a team as I've seen. They're not that tall, but they get after it. They're physical, and you can tell their coach demands a lot of details on the defensive end as well. So I'm looking forward to this matchup because I think it would be a real barometer for us to see if we can match a team that plays really hard every time they go out.
Have you found the atmosphere's changed as well? Just in, you know, the composure and the focus of this team after getting a couple of wins so far in the second half of the season?
Yeah, I think it's been strange. I mean, we came back in the second half, and I think our guys are pretty confident despite the record. We know we have some talented guys on the roster, but it was about gaining that chemistry, and we knew we didn't have that in the first part of the year, and we're still at times we struggle with that, but at the end of the day, each game we look at that as an opportunity to get better as a team, and if we can get some good chemistry down the stretch here, I think we can be pretty good.
Has it made any difference if you've been able to have so many home games in this second half? You know, 5-game homestand, and then you just have to go down the street through a game of Laurier, and you're back home again. Has that been a positive, or does it make any difference at all with the sort of the west side of the schedule?
No, it's been a positive. I think our guys are focused, and we have a chance to kind of practice and then get ready for the game at home. So from the coaching standpoint, it's great to be able to play games at home and watch the guys play confident in front of the home crowd.
Well, we will take a break as it is halftime. We'll have an interview coming up shortly. You're watching Warriors men's basketball, pardon me, women's basketball. We're chatting with the men's coach here on SSN Canada. Warriors trailing currently 45-29. We'll be back with our halftime on SSN.
I am a warrior. I am a warrior.
we are back at the physical activities complex on the campus of the University of Waterloo. I'm Sam Charles. You're watching Warriors basketball, women's basketball. The Warriors trailing Guelph 45-29, and it was sort of some lapses there, latter stages of the first quarter and within stretches in that second quarter that have enabled the Guelph Gryphons to jump out to this lead of 16. Warriors being led on the offensive attack by Sam McIntyre's 7 points. She's 2 of 3 from the floor, 3 of 4 from the charity stripe with 2 rebounds in her 11 minutes. Turned the ball over one time. Loheed, Quincy, and Person with 4 points. Bear and Rodriguez with 3. And Stojakovic and Spiropoulos with 2. Rounding out the Warriors, 29 points. They've been just out-rebounded 24-22, but it's the turnover story. Warriors have turned the ball over 17 times compared to the 7 by the Gryphons. Warriors shooting paltry 27.6%, 8 of 29 from the field, 1 of 6 from three-point land for 17%, and 12 of 16 from the charity stripe, 75%. The Gryphons being led by a great game by the sister of former Warrior, Kyla Goodhoeft. Kyla with 14 points, 2 rebounds, 9 steals in her 12 minutes. She also had 3 assists. She was 6 of 11 from the field, 1 of 3 from beyond the arc, and 1 of 2 from the charity stripe. McFadden and Douglas with 8 points each. Douglas also with 7 rebounds in her 13 minutes. Catherine Short with 5 points, 3 rebounds in her 10 minutes. McTavish with 4 points, 3 rebounds. And then Rick Peters, Freeman, and Tilly all with 2 points in their action so far tonight in the first half. Griffin shot 42% from the field, 18 of 43. We're very close from long range, 1 of 10, and from the charity stripe, 8 of 14. Earlier this season, we had an opportunity to sit down with a number of the Warriors to chat about the upcoming season. One of those was Madison Bear. Here's that interview now.
My name is Madison Bear. I play guard. My number is number 8. And my major is studies. In my first year, there was a lot of rookies that came in. And then last year, we all moved up to second year, and there was only one third year. So we were still the majority of the team. And so here we're moving into the third year. We're still pretty close to the majority of the team. The biggest change is that a lot of us stayed here this summer. So we all practiced together all summer. We were in the weight room together. So hopefully this season is going to be very promising. My first time I played basketball, I helped out one of the teams in the Hamilton area just didn't have enough players for a couple games of their season, so my dad just kind of threw me in there. I didn't really know what I was doing, but I instantly got hooked, and a lot of my friends from elementary school played rep basketball for a long time, so I just kind of fell right into it. I think I've got a lot more confidence over the last 3 years. One of my main areas to work on this summer was the confidence to drive to the net instead of just taking always the outside shot. So hopefully I can be more a threat on the three-point line. And health studies is part of the applied health science. And so I get to take a lot of kin courses, but also health courses. So that was kind of a bonus to me. And hopefully I'd like to go into something medical in the future. I'm not really sure where I'll go, but we'll see how it goes. My mom is a nurse. And my dad majored in chemistry when he went to school, and so like I've just always really been interested in sciences. And then I came to Waterloo, and I realized I could take biology and chemistry and all that, but also take the more public health side of it, so looking at populations and health in that aspect. So I really liked that. So when it comes to juggling athletics and academics, it was really difficult in my first year. I really had to get the hang of it. I didn't do all too well in my classes, but it was all just getting used to it, and then last year I ended up being an academic All-Canadian, so you just have to get the hang of it. I think one of my tricks is just always having my day planned out. It's really a lot easier, I'd say, with basketball because practice is already scheduled, weights is already scheduled, your classes are scheduled for you, so there's really only certain chunks of time that you can use. So I think that's my little trick, is just using those wisely. One of my guilty pleasures would be peanut butter. I love to eat peanut butter on almost anything. On like the main course, like chicken, pork, stuff like that.
There you have it, an inside look at Madison Bear. Madison Bear with 3 points so far tonight, 1 of 2 from the field. That one was a three-pointer, also 2 defensive rebounds, 2 turnovers, and 1 steal in her 13 minutes of action in the first half of the game between Guelph and Waterloo. Guelph leads 45-29 as our halftime continues here from the pack. You're watching University of Waterloo Warriors women's basketball on SSN.
I'm ready to settle the score. Motion in the air, the enemy in front.
Back here at the back on the campus of the University of Waterloo. You are watching Warriors women's basketball, and we are just wrapping up halftime. The Warriors, as we mentioned the last few games as well, are really suffering from the injury bug, not necessarily illness, but just various degrees of injuries. Seven players today in their civilian attire. Ivana Yurik, hasn't seen any game action right now with concussion, not expected back for the foreseeable future. Janelle Ullman, who just got her air cast or her boot off today, which is a good sign for the Warriors, so they're hoping to have her back very soon. Laura Bosser's also with her boot off this very day as well. She might be back into practice as early as tomorrow, the next day. They're not quite sure when Ullman will be back in there due to her injury. Laura Burnett is out for the season with the doctor still uncertain with whether or not it's a torn ACL or a meniscus issue, but issue with her knee, so not expected back this season. Alicia Hoffman has sustained a concussion in training camp. Might be back soon, but it's still up in the air. They have to go through a series of tests. And so far, those tests have not come across. And it's when we talk about tests, they have to do a number of physical activities and not have any of the concussion symptoms come back. Then they need to practice to make sure there's no issues there. And so they need to make sure that they're in the right, well, literally the right headspace in order to come back and play. Kayla Carl, ACL 2 years ago. Got an issue with a Cyclops scar, so she's probably not back. She only has about 15 degrees of motion, so she's probably not coming back anytime soon. And Marty Colleen, who's tried to do those concussion tests in the last little while, she's had a lot of difficulties going through those without having any of the symptoms reappear. It's been an issue for her, and they're hoping to have back before the end of the season, but you don't want to rush things. If you look back the last few seasons, Colleen Quinlan, for instance, had such a promising university career, kind of goes sideways when it comes to basketball because of the concussions and trying to get back too early. You need to make sure you take your time, make sure your body's healthy before you can get back onto the court. And rounding out the Warriors injury lineup here is Allie Vonk, ACL a year and a half ago, and she's, according to Coach, not quite ready to get back. Warriors trailing by 16, it's 45-29. And the Warriors start with possession here in the third quarter. McIntyre, right wing, up top to Kulin Develin, who has a ball stolen by Goodhoeft. For Goodhoeft, that's her 10th steal of the game. She got it over to Freeman, who misses, and down with it McIntyre to Rodriguez. Bear down to Quincy by herself, who had it knocked away and knocked out of bounds by Van Balkum. So the Warriors will retain possession with 18 on the shot clock. Inbound to Kunze. Then to Kulin Develin. Back over to Kunze. Drives baseline. And her pass intended cross-court to Bear on the perimeter is stolen by Freeman. He played just over 30 seconds of the third quarter. Goodhoeft. Lobbing up high into Douglas, one-on-one with the shorter McIntyre, who plays her well, however, as Douglas misses and Sam grabs the rebound. The foul trouble on Kunze at this point. Rodriguez for three. Top of the key, she hits it. And the Warriors creep a little bit closer at 45-32 and then allow this easy break as the defense just crumbled in an easy lay-in from Short. Guelph played Windsor pretty tough for the majority of their game on Saturday. Kulin Develin to the near elbow, outside into Bear, being guarded by Short. She'll go to the right wing, then swing it up to Kulin Develin. Down into Kunze, through the double team, but the shot clock expires. No shot, and the Warriors turn the ball over. According to Coach O'Brien, they gave up those 15 points at the lead of 15 at a half and then played even throughout the rest of the game. They allowed the two All-Canadians on that squad. Nice pass, I'm short, to Douglas, who easily finishes from the left side. They allowed those two to score 42. That's Williams and Clemenceau. And nobody else on their team was in double digits, but those two single-handedly took down the Guelph Gryphons. End-to-end goes short, misses. Kunze falls to the ground and then had to go off the leg of short out of bounds. And Kate still playing a little bit tentatively after getting that gouge, bleeding from her forehead, wearing a bandage today. But she's out there, quite the warrior indeed. Uses a screen from Bear. Had the ball knocked away to Coolin Devlin and to Bear to the elbow. Outside to McIntyre. Lobs it inside into Rodriguez. One-on-one with McFadden. Sort of handed off behind her into Kunze, who shot strong. And could have down with the rebound and quickly on transition on a 2-on-2. And then she'll wait for some help. Short over to McFadden for a long three. That long rebound is picked up by McFadden. And she'll get the putback by herself. And Kate did not box out the shooter, giving McFadden an easy bucket. McIntyre up into Bear. Wholesale changes as the Warriors are about to substitute four players. The next whistle. Bear. Rodriguez loses the handle to the left wing. To Bear, then in to Kunze. Got stuck underneath the backboard and lobbed it off the side of the backboard. And Douglas came down with the rebound. Douglas with seven rebounds in the first half. And a turnover by Guelph. Bear and McIntyre. Bear will pull up with a jumper. Hits it. She had McIntyre on the far side. 6:22 to go in the third quarter. Warriors trailing 51-34. McFadden driving. Has it rejected by McIntyre out of bounds, and it will remain Guelph ball with 15 on the shot clock. And here come Spiropoulos, Loheed, Stojakovic, and Person replacing Lindevlin, Rodriguez, Kunze, and McIntyre. Short, inbounds, just in the nick of time, into Freeman. She tries a little floater. That doesn't go. Spiropoulos knocked it right over to Bear. And Maddie gets it up to Spiropoulos. Over into Person. That ball was nearly turned over. And Erica, trying to get the handle on the ball, drives baseline, puts it up off the glass, and that one falls. Warriors going with a little more speed and height at this point. So it looked like the initial lineup out here to start the half just wasn't quite into gear just yet. Goodoff gets stuck, running into two Warriors. Over to Short, who had it knocked right back to her by Person. Lobs it over to Duff as the shot clock expires. And another shot clock violation by the Gryphons offense, not really able to fire on their own. As Rampato replaces Douglas. It's the second stop by the Warriors defense and a strong D, but it just hasn't been consistent. Fadden will pick up the foul. Into the game, Tilly and Van Bulkum replacing Goodhoft and McFadden. Leading scorer in the game currently is Kayla Goodhoft with 14 points in her 17 minutes. Person, right wing, when it gets to Akovic to provide her with a screen to the left. Instead, Erica decides to go herself to the right, drives the lane, no defender in sight, and lays it in. Blew by the initial defender. Short, lobbing it up to Freeman. She gets right around Bear. Help came, and the pass intended for Empato went off Loheed, right to Bear. Maddie backs up, drives in again, then backs up once again up to Person, 15 on the shot clock. Over Spiropoulos on the perimeter, lobbing up to Loheed in a triple team. Takes down her dribble, hands it off to Person, thought about a shot, gets past Tilly, diving in right between two Gryphon defenders, Rebound picked up by Stojakovic, and a whistle on the play. Looks like Van Bulkham will pick it up. Sam McIntyre will replace Bear for the Warriors. Warriors fighting their way back into this one. Warriors currently on a mini run, a 9-6 run. That's how they've started this third quarter. McIntyre bounces it in to Stojakovic and Asparopoulos. Well executed there by the Warriors, keeping the ball way up high above the defenders, and the bigs for the Warriors do a marvelous job distributing the ball and getting it in the bucket. Short. Triple team. Outside to Tilly for three. That one's strong. Down with the rebound, Rampato. Into Van Bulkham for three. That one she hits from the left wing is the contest from McIntyre, a couple or a split second late. Warriors trailing by 14. 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. McIntyre over to Person. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Lobs it into Loheeb. Back over to Person. She'll try to return the favor for a three. Does so right in front of the Warriors bench. The Warriors trail by 11. It's 54-43. And Bulkham, just moments ago, had a three. Bounces it up to Short. She'll put up a long jumper. That one's good. For Short, she's now at 7 points. Tilly saves the ball from going to bounds. Another turnover by the Warriors. They had 17 in the first half. Freeman into Tilly, lobbing over to Short. Sparopoulos there late. The shot short. Gia pulls it down, waits for a ball handler, and that's not Stojakovic. Not known for that, as she has the ball stripped right out of her hands by Van Bulkham, who traveled, no call. Drives in from the left side, too strong on the shot. McIntyre fighting for loose ball with Rampato. And out with it. That Mealy was Short, who got it to Freeman. She'll put up a shot with 12 on the shot clock, and sort of the turnaround three is good. And a timeout is called as Coach Slip has some words with the officials. A clear travel on the last play and no whistle. The Guelph Gryphons Short started with the right foot as the pivot, switched to the left, back to the right, and then ran, drove the lane. Pardon me, 2:55 to go in the third quarter. Warriors trailing by 16. They had gotten it within 11 and have not been able to get the ball, really been the story of much of this game, into a ball handler's hands to push the ball into the front court, and it caused a number of turnovers. The Warriors now sitting with 21 turnovers compared to the Gryphons' only 10. Warriors have improved their shooting a bit. They were at 27% at the half, now at 37%. They've been shooting 43%, up from their 42 in the first half. Warriors just are giving up way too many opportunities to opponents, as the Gryphons have had 13 more shots from the field than the Warriors. Gryphons 23 of 54, the Warriors 15 of 41. Rebounding is about the same this game, with the Gryphons at 28 total rebounds, the Warriors with 26. Outlet pass, Kunze drives in, misses. Person grabs the rebound out to McIntyre. Ripped it away from the Gryphons player. And then a whistle on the play. Away from the play. The foul is going to go against the Gryphons. Goes against Rampato. That's her third. The third team foul on the Gryphons. And in comes McTavish for the Gryphons. McIntyre lobbed it into Person, into Kusi, the turnaround jumper high up the glass, rattles around and falls. Nice play by Kate down low. Not even down that low, I suppose, as she was on the high post and hits the ball to fall. Henrik Peters had the ball nearly stripped from Kunze, and that diverted her attention from putting the ball into the cylinder. Kate nearly loses the handle, picks it up again, going end to end. Then knock it off McTavish out of bounds. It will remain Warriors ball, 16 on the shot clock. McIntyre inbound, 2:18 to go in the third quarter. Inbounds to Person right under the basket. Turns right around Van Balkum, but the right hook is too strong. Men's game coming up following this one. Just have to click on the men's link at ssncanada.com. Another turnover by the Gryphons. McIntyre up to Person on a 2-on-1 over to McIntyre. Rodriguez to Person to McIntyre, and McIntyre finishes from the right side with a lay-in. 1:45 to go in the third quarter. Warriors trailing by 12. Kunze guarding Freeman. And then a moving screen is called on Van Balkum. O'Brien of the Gryphons doesn't like that call at all. McTavish replaced by Douglas. Person inbounding for the Warriors. And we'll do it all over again. Kunze takes the ball over midcourt. Over to Rodriguez. The Person. Person faking a couple of shots. Faked left, goes right. Pulls it back again. Bumped in the back from Freeman. Lobbed it into the paint. Douglas comes up with that ball, though. And with 1:20 to go in the third quarter, the big Jasmine Douglas getting into Gudduf. And Gudduf nails the 15-footer. Gudduf's with that's her 16th point of the ball game. Person comes to the near side. Lobbing it into Kunze. One-on-one with the much smaller Inward Peters. Goes out of bounds. Warriors will retain possession with 7 on the shot clock. And Beattie comes in to replace Van Balkum. McIntyre inbound. Does so to Kunze. Kate backing in on Gudduf. The reverse, too strong. Goes out of bounds. And it's Guelph ball. Warriors have made a couple of runs and gotten the score within 14, pardon me, and within 11 at top, but haven't been able to get it back down to single figures. Henry Peters over to Freeman. Into Beattie for 3, right wing. Rattles out. Rodriguez comes through the crowd with the rebound. 35 seconds to go in the third quarter. Jackie driving in from the right side. Bounces it out to McIntyre. And Anaspropoulos, one-on-one, nice move, but not quite enough English on the ball. It rattles out, and the Gryphons come down with it. 20 seconds to go in the third quarter, and Kunze steps in the passing lane, steals the ball, and is fouled on the lay-in attempt from the left side. She'll go to the line to shoot 2. Kate on the evening so far, 6 points, 5 rebounds in 21 minutes, 2 fouls, and misses the first free throw attempt. Kate was 2 of 3 from the charity stripe in the first half. That one she misses as well, but jumping for it is Rodriguez. She'll drive baseline, 7 seconds to go, outside of Person for 3 from the right wing. That one's a bit strong, and goes up over the enclosure of the backboard. Kunze takes a seat. Rodriguez takes a seat. Kulin Devlin comes in, along with Bear. Warriors with Kulin Devlin, Stojakovic. They have 6 Warriors on the court right now as the Warriors head coach, Tyler, decides who else will come off, and that's Erica Person. So the Warriors with Bear, Kulin Devlin, McIntyre, Stojakovic, and Spiropoulos. 2.1 seconds left in the quarter. Warriors trailing by 14, 61-47. Beattie inbounds into Gudduf, and time will expire in the quarter with the score 61-47, Guelph leads Waterloo. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors Women's Basketball on SN.
the sweat is dripping down off my nose and through the threat. That's how my summer always goes.
In the air, the enemy in front of me. I am a warrior. Glory will be mine. I'm gonna shine, just wait and see. I am a warrior. I see the reckoning. I see everything. I know what I'm for. I am a warrior.
I'm getting ready for the war. I've started pacing. I'm ready to spread to the storm.
Tension in the air, the enemy in front of me.
I am a warrior. Glory will be mine. I'm gonna shine, just wait and see. I am a warrior. I see a reckoning. I see everything. I know what I'm for.
I am a warrior.
Back here at the Physical Activities Complex on the campus of the University of Waterloo, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching University of Waterloo women's basketball on SSN. Warriors outscored the Gryphons in that third quarter, 18-16. But it was the second quarter, which has been their downfall for much of this season, as they were outscored by 11 points, 23-12. It's hard to climb up through a deficit like that, and the Warriors are working pugnaciously to do just that here at the start of the fourth quarter. Freeman and Indrick Peters puts up the shot just inside the perimeter. That's strong, and down with the rebound is Bayer. Waiting for some help, gets it up to Stojakovic, then into Kulindelin over half court, and they set up the half court offense. Lynn Devlin quarterbacking that in her first year. Over to McIntyre. Lobbing it into Spiropoulos. The right hook is too strong, and Douglas comes down with it. And then the Gryphons turn the ball over with just a slight press by the Warriors. Spiropoulos, Stojakovic, and McIntyre replaced by Loheed, Quincy, and Person. For the Warriors, as Short and McFadden replace Beatty and Inrig Peters. Person, Nicola Devlin, grabs that ball, getting it outside to Person, fake the shot, drives in, over to Quincy, outside into Bear from just inside the arc. That one falls, nice high arcing shot from Maddie. Again, the Warriors trail by 12. Goodhoft. Over to Douglas. Near elbow. That's well strong. And Person comes up with it. Warriors have an opportunity to get it even below double digits this deficit. Loheed pushed in the back by Freeman. Over to Bear. Top to the elbow. Double team. Fight for loose ball. And it's a jump ball called. Possession arrow heading Guelph direction. Warriors need to keep moving the ball around. They've been gotten stuck right there on a couple of other instances. Warriors keep possession as the possession arrow was incorrect. Quincy driving in, had the ball stripped by Short. Four on the shot clock as the Warriors will again inbound in the front court. Quincy will do the honors. No, they'll have Kulin Devlin do the honors right in front of her own bench. Inside. And that's a shot clock violation as Quincy couldn't get the ball up. 8:20 to go in this final quarter of regulation. Freeman for three. The corners strong. Goodhoff with the rebound. Well, the Goodhoff having a great game tonight. And the Warriors grab the rebound. Quincy out of that melee over to Loheed. Down into Bear, right under the basket, around McFadden. A touch shot from right under the basket. That one falls. and another turnover by Guelph. Warriors trailing by 10 now have a chance to bring that deficit even under 10. Laura Bossers, one of the captains of this Warrior squad in her civvies tonight, has put the air cast back on. Person comes to the near side right in front of her own bench. Bossers cheering on her teammates. Person almost lost the ball and then threw it away as she was falling out of bounds to Douglas. To Freeman. Back over to Douglas. Well contested. Well played by Bear, but Douglas is too tall and easily gets it off the glass and in. 7:24 to go. Warriors trailing by 12 as Kunze ran into short. And Kate will go to the line. Those sorts of opportunities the Warriors haven't really been taking advantage of getting to the line. They've had teams in foul trouble, but aren't aggressive enough getting the ball into the paint, driving to the basket. But today, they've been to the charity stripe four more times than Guelph. Make this five and six more times than Guelph. Second shot's up. It's good. So it's 63-53, although the scoreboard hasn't been updated just yet. There we go. 7:20 to go in the fourth quarter. Warriors trailing by 10. Warriors have dropped their turnover numbers. The shot from Freeman is strong. Douglas soars up above Lohe. Then she'll put up a jumper, hits that one. Douglas having a good game so far tonight. Now up 12 points, 12 rebounds. The double-double, and there's still 6:45 to go in the fourth quarter. Lohe backing in on Rampato, puts up a little left hook, doesn't go, and the ball goes out of bounds off the Gryphons. McIntyre and Rodriguez re-enter the game for the Warriors. They replace Kulin Devlin and Bear. Person inbounds it into Lohe. Person's jumper is short. McIntyre saves it, but couldn't quite get the hang time over the baseline and stepped out of bounds. Warriors with McIntyre, Person, Rodriguez, Kunze, and Lohe on the court. McFadden, Goodhoofed, Rampato, Douglas, and Freeman for Guelph. McFadden over Freeman. Lobbing it to Douglas. Gets right around Kunze, but their shot's too strong off the glass, and down with the rebound with Rampato. And a jump ball call. This Person had her hands on as well. Spiropoulos will replace Lohe. Guelph leads by 12, 65-53. Lots of time left. As our lead official, Ian Pierce, has some word with the officiating table. Freeman inbounds to Goodhoofed. Almost has it go out of her hands out of bounds. Her three ball's too strong. And it goes off of the backboard holder. The mechanism that keeps it up. Person outlet pass is stolen by McFadden. Pass was intended for Rodriguez. McFadden driving in from the right side. That doesn't go. Kunze had it for a second. The rebound. Spiropoulos had it for a second. But she stepped on the baseline and she was fighting for possession of the ball with Rampato and Goodhoofed. 15 on the shot clock for Guelph. Inbound to Douglas. Hands it back over to Freeman. Lobs it cross court into Rampato. Quick shot. That one's strong. Spiropoulos knocked it to herself and gets it up to Rodriguez, who will push the ball over half court. Down right under the basket to Kunze, who was fouled by Douglas. Good court vision by Rodriguez to find Kunze all by herself under the basket. McTavish and Tilly will enter the game for Guelph, replacing Goodhoeft and Douglas. 5:36 to go with Kunze at the line. Kate misses the first, too strong on it. Kate is 2 of 12 from the, make that 3 of 13 from the field, and is now 5 of 8 from the charity stripe this evening. Warriors trailing by 11 with 5.5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. McTavish hands it to McFadden. Brings the ball to the right side, over to Freeman, back over to McFadden for 3, top of the key, that one's off. Loose ball's picked up by McIntyre, stays on the sideline, tiptoed, but eventually stepped on the sideline, or where pass over to Rodriguez hit the sideline. Freeman. It's the ball well off on the perimeter, and then a whistle on the play is... They're waiting for the shot clock to start, and it had not. It's at 24 currently. So 20 on the shot clock, and Guelph will inbound. And Waterloo calls a timeout. 5:13 go in the fourth quarter with the Warriors trailing by 11, 65-54. You're watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN. Warriors have managed to make this into a ball game, but every time they get close, they have found themselves, or they found Guelph having an answer, and it's been shooting that's been on and off for the Gryphons tonight. Get it in to McTavish, over to McFadden. Guelph only shooting 39% from the field. And Rampato is going to be called on the offensive foul down low on Kunze as they got tangled up in the paint. And if anything, the Warriors have gotten a number of calls in their favor tonight, and it's they need to make them count, however, with these turnovers. Here's Rodriguez with the ball stolen by McFadden, who looked like she traveled, but maybe just bounced, dribbled the ball a little too high, lays it in from the left side. 13-point lead for the Gryphons as McIntyre gets the elbow into Kunze, over to Spiropoulos with a quick jumper. That one's off. Person grabs the rebound right through Tilly. Cross-court pass into Rodriguez. Thought about a shot, goes towards the baseline, stops as McFadden right in her face. Those two played in club against one another, and Rodriguez is pushed as she tried the pass over to Person, and ball goes out of bounds. It's Guelph ball. 4:12 to go in this final quarter of regulation. The Warriors trailing by 13, 67-54. McFadden into Freeman. Over to Tilly by herself under the basket. Kunze came late. The reverse doesn't go, and Kate grabs the rebound. She'll push the ball down court. She has McIntyre to her right. Runs into McFadden. Loses the ball and turns the ball over. Warriors now with 28 turnovers. The Gryphons with 14. Freeman to the right wing. Crossover dribble just inside the arc. Gets that one to fall. fourth-year player for the Gryphons. Frame now with 7 points in her 27 minutes. Nice move by Skoropis, driving into the paint with the left hook. We approach the three-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Freeman into Rampato. Rampato turnaround jumper is strong, but goes off the iron a couple of times and in. Person down court into Rodriguez. At the top of the baseline, after she corralled the ball, she'll drive into right, had her head down for a minute, kicks it outside to Spiropoulos. Over to McIntyre by herself, well in perimeter, gets right to the arc, and there comes Freeman to defend her. Then lobs it into Kunsey, who tried to pass it into Spiropoulos, a whistle on the play. Goodhoeft comes back in. She's the leading scorer in the ballgame for either squad with 16 points. Douglas of the Gryphons has 14 and McFadden with 12. It was one of the keys to the game for Coach O'Brien. He wanted to see his squad have more than one, two, maybe three or four players in double digits. And a couple of them right on the precipice with Short and Freeman with 7 points, still 2:50 to go in the fourth quarter. And there's 14 put on the shot clock. Warriors inbounding from the baseline. McIntyre doing the honors, does so to Spiropoulos. And Spiropoulos with the carry or the double dribble, not quite sure which one they called. It could have been either. Wanted to get into the post. And here are the Gryphons looking to extend their lead. Tilly gets past Spiropoulos. Her pass intended for Douglas. Broken up by the Warriors. And Rodriguez comes down with it. Into the corner for three from Person. Hits it. Sweet stroke from Erica Person. Tried to get in front of McFadden. McFadden, little stutter step as she went inside the arc. Gets the long two to fall. Warriors trailing by 14. 2:10 to go in the fourth quarter. McIntyre into Spiropoulos, backing in on Douglas. Nice move, but a little too strong on the shot. And then a foul, a bit of frustration there by Gia. Picks up the foul. This is the first team foul on the Warriors here in the fourth quarter. It's the second one on Spiropoulos. And a timeout called by the Gryphons with 1:55 to go. Warriors trailing 73-59. It's called Gryphons team. The record so far this season, 4-9. Last season had a record of 10-12 under Coach O'Brien. It's a team full of new players. They haven't won, we mentioned, since November. Coach O'Brien gave the squad a C grading at this point in the season, as 11 of his 16 players are in their first or second year. Sounds very similar to the position the Warriors are in, too, but he's been able to, in terms of recruitment, bring in some bigger names, like the Erica McFadden, who's been has an immediate impact on this Griffin squad. Her season high 22 came against Queens at the beginning of the season, but averaging just over 12 points per game. We got Kate McTavish in her second year at Waterloo, a strong rookie season, earned OUA West All-Rookie spot. And the Warriors just have not been able to claim those sorts of spots, although you look down some of the first-year players and who've been getting time. Jackie Rodriguez, although scoring just 6 points a game, has been a starter on this squad and has handled a lot of the ball-handling duties, and now with the injury to Laura Burnett and Laura Bossers, sees a lot more playing time. 1:55 to go. The Warriors trailing by 14 at 73-59. Freeman will come in, replacing McTavish. McTavish McFadden over to Tilly, over to Douglas, who can't finish, but she's fouled, and Jasmine will go to the line in the act of shooting. For Douglas, looking to increase her point total today. She has 14 points at this point, make that 15, and 13 rebounds in her 24 minutes. Person about to re-enter the game for the Warriors. One goes off the front of the iron and the glass and in. And Person comes in to replace McIntyre. Warriors trailing now by 16. It's 75-59. Rodriguez gets over half court. Uses a screen. Couldn't see a switch is made. And then the pick and roll run to perfection, but Rodriguez's pass is just not strong enough. Indicate stolen by the Gryphons. Goodhoft up to Freeman, 50 on the shot clock, into Tilly, then into McFadden, to Douglas. They try to trap her on the baseline, and a fight for the loose ball. Jump ball called between Goodhoft and Person. And possession arrow heading in the Warriors' direction, so they take possession. 1:21 to go in the fourth quarter. Warriors trailing 75-59. And Tilly steals the ball from her old teammate, Kate Kunze, and lays it in from the left side. Bear will now push the ball over half court. She'll drive in from the left side, has it rejected by Douglas. That's her first block of the ball game. 1 minute, 3 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Kunze tried the right hook. It was a clothesline right to underneath the iron and goes out of bounds off the Warriors, and it will be Guelph ball. Less than a minute to go. Looks like the Warriors will drop their 32nd regular season game in a row tonight. Last victory coming November 2011. Tilly over to Freeman into the corner, Goodhoft. Then into McFadden, who hits the three from the right wing. As the officials just felt that the clock wound down a little too quickly, they're going to add a couple of seconds on. Currently sitting at 35.3 seconds. Crowd continues to file into the physical activities complex. Getting set for the men's action. They reset clock to 47. I think it's supposed to be 37. Men's game starting at about 8 p.m. here on SSN Canada. You'll just have to click the link for the men's game between Guelph and Waterloo. 37 seconds are on the clock. Warriors are trailing by a score of 80-59. Person brings the ball into the front court. Over to Spropolis. She'll drive left side and lay it in. Light over Jasmine Douglas. 25 seconds to go and the Warriors trail by 19. McFadden into Douglas by herself. Easily lays it in. Looks up at the scoreboard, sees there's 17 seconds remaining. Bounces it up to Rodriguez. And one more play for the Warriors tonight. Next game for the Warriors is Saturday against the Windsor Lancers, one of the best teams in the nation. Windsor right up there with Brock, undefeated on the season with perfect records of 13-0. Tilly over to Douglas. As time will expire, and that's how things end tonight with the Warriors dropping this one 82-61. Running down the scores for you for the winning Guelph Gryphons and their 82 points, led by Jasmine Douglas's 18 points, 13 rebounds. Erica McFadden with 17 points, 1 rebound. Kayla Goodhoff with 16 points, 4 rebounds. Catherine Short with 7 points, 3 rebounds. Dana Van Bulkum with 5 points, one rebound, and McTavish and Tilly with 4 points. Ingrid Peters had 2 points, as did Vanessa Rampato, rounding out the grid and scoring for the Warriors, led by Erica Persons, 14 points and 3 rebounds. Sam McIntyre with 9 points, along with Kate Kunze and Maddie Bear, also all with 9 points. Bear with 4 rebounds, Kunze with 7, and McIntyre with 5. Jackie Rodriguez with 6 points, 4 rebounds. Loheed with 4 points and 6 rebounds in her 15 minutes, and Natasha Stojakovic with 2 points, 4 rebounds in her limited action in the ballgame today. Warriors again dropping at 82-61. Warriors shot 35% from the field, the Gryphons 44%. Warriors shot 68% from the charity stripe compared to the Gryphons 63, but the Warriors turned the ball over 31 times, and the Gryphons just 16. Warriors were out-rebounded 39-35. For our camera operator, Jalise, our producers are Dan Ackerman and Chris Gilbert. The Associate Athletic Director of the University of Waterloo is Kristen Stapleton. The Athletic Director is Bob Copeland. I'm Sam Charles. The next University of Waterloo women's basketball action, Saturday, 2 p.m. tip-off against the Windsor Lancers. You've been watching Warriors women's basketball on SSN Canada.